عائشة رضي الله عنها, the wife of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, she shares with us a very personal moment in her life. She says, one day I was with Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, and he was in a cheerful mood. So I said to him, Ya Rasulullah, make dua for me. So he said, Allahumma aghfir li Aisha. May Allah forgive Aisha. Ma taqaddama min dhanbiha wa ma ta'akhkhara. And he continued, Oh Allah, forgive Aisha. All her sins, the past sins, the future sins, the ones that she commits in private and the ones that she commits in public. And Aisha was so happy that she started to laugh. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked her, did that dua please you? Brothers, I want you to imagine that you were living at the tomb of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he was your best friend, and you asked him, make dua for me, and he made the same dua for you. How happy would you be? So he says to Aisha, did that dua please you? She says, Ya Rasulullah, how could that not please anyone? He says, Wallahi, by Allah, إنها لدعوة لأمتي في كل صلاة. He says, by Allah, that is the same dua I make for my ummah in every single one of my prayers. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم made that same dua for me. How much does the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم love us? He would cry in front of the Sahaba. He would cry and he would say, I miss my brothers, the ones that I love. And they would say, Ya Rasulullah, aren't we your brothers? He would say, no, you are my companions. But my brothers are the ones that will come after me. And they will believe in me. And they would never have seen me. This is you, brothers. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is crying. Because he misses you. He would stay the night praying to Allah, crying out to Allah, my ummah, ummati, ummati. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is crying for you. When was the last time you cried for the Prophet? The Prophet would give khutbah and he would lean on a tree as he would give the khutbah until they built him the minbar. The following week, standing on this minbar, the companions would say, we heard the tree crying like it was a little baby. The tree was crying because it missed Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If this tree, brothers, this tree which is not a living thing, it's not obligated to love Rasulullah, was crying because it missed Rasulullah. And other people who say Muhammad is Rasulullah, are we not more worthy to cry for missing him than this tree? Are we not worthy? The companions were sacrificed so much when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam passed away. And Bilal, the one who would call the adhan, he could not do it. He would sit in the Prophet's mosque and he would imagine looking at the house of Aisha where it was the grave of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he would imagine the Prophet walking across the rawda and saying to Bilal, arihna biha ya Bilal, comfort us with it ya Bilal, make the adhan for prayer. And so Bilal could not stand living in the city of Medina without Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Every street, every corner, every rock, everything would remind him this is where the Prophet ﷺ was. So he leaves the city, as many companions did, going for jihad. And too many years later, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave victory to the Muslims in Jerusalem, and the Sahaba would be reunited for the first time in so long since the death of the Prophet. And they would see Bilal, who had not given adhan for 6 years. And they would say to him, Ya Bilal, adhin lana, make adhan for us just one last time. And he would say, Nafa'adurin, please, I can't, it's too painful. They would say, please, they ask Umar, Umar, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, please speak to him. Until Umar spoke to him and he agreed. And say, Bilal would get up to make this adhan, the first time since the death of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And he would call the adhan. The memories, the sweet times, the fragrance of the Rasulullah, his warmth, his compassion, would come back to the Sahaba and they would all cry. Could you imagine Umar crying like a little child? And Bilal would struggle through the adhan and he would continue until he would get to the part in the adhan, Ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah, until he would break down and cry and he could not continue anymore. Many years later, when Bilal was on his deathbed, dying, and his wife would say to him, "What sorrow! What sorrow!" He would say, "No. What happiness! What happiness! What joy! For tomorrow I will be with the one that I love. I will be with Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam." How many of us cry for Rasulullah? How many of us love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam like the way he should be loved? Oh.